Let's say you have two 3D scans and you want to merge them into one object without losing any textures. Make sure the objects both have enough geometry. If not, add a subdiff modifier and apply it. With dense scans, however, it's a good idea to remove double vertices to avoid issues later. To do this, press M in edit mode and choose by distance. Use a Boolean cutter to remove any parts that you don't need. Apply the Boolean modifier and remove the bounding box. Move and rotate the objects to overlap as desired. You can use proportional editing to adjust the way the objects overlap. Enable proportional editing by pressing O and scroll the mouse wheel to change its influence radius. It's important that both objects have the same UV map name. Otherwise, one of the objects will lose its texture after you join them. The name doesn't matter as long as it's the same for both objects. Select both objects and press Ctrl and plus on the numpad to join them using Bool tool. Now they are merged into one object. I recommend inspecting the model on the inside. If the intersecting parts are not removed, try enabling Hole Tolerant on the modifier. Apply the Boolean modifier and remove the bounding box. Duplicate this object and hide the original. Switch to Scope mode. I like to use a matcap, it just makes it easier to see what you're doing. Enable DIN Topo with constant detail. You can sample part of the model to get its resolution. DIN Topo allows us to sculpt on the seam more easily, but it removes all texture information, which is why we are using a duplicate object. Use the Clay Strips brush and Smooth to blend the two parts together. To get the colors back from the texture, we can bake the original texture to color attributes, formerly known as vertex colors. Add a color attribute to the duplicate. In the outliner, unhide and select the original textured mesh. Hold Ctrl and select the duplicate as well. Please note that if you do this selection order in the 3D viewport, you must hold Shift instead of Ctrl. In the Cycles Bake menu, for the bake type, select the texture channel you wish to bake from. In my case, I had the texture set up as an emission shader on the original mesh, so I have to choose Emit. But if your original texture is plugged into the Diffuse channel, choose Diffuse and disable Direct and Indirect so there's no influence of lighting. Check Selected to Active to bake from the original textured mesh to the duplicate. As output, choose Active Color Attribute. Make sure you are in object mode and click Bake. When it's done, hide the original mesh again. To see the colors in object or sculpt mode, enable Color Attribute in the Viewport Shading options. In case the bake didn't work perfectly, try increasing the extrusion value. This works like a bake cage. Make sure the objects are still selected in the right order and click Bake again. In my experience, an extrusion value of 0.2 often works well. You can use the Paint tool in Sculpt mode to paint on the mesh. By pressing S, you sample the color under the cursor. A low brush strength value helps to blend the colors more gradually. For more sculpting tips, check my sculpting playlist or get my Blender Secrets ebook. There is also a free sample if you want to check that out first.